You are tuned in BBC Radio Leeds, Sheffield and York. This is the evening show with me, Sanchez Payne. And as we all know, right now, we are living through a very, very odd and weird time. It's unprecedented. And these kind of problems that we're dealing with require people to think a little bit outside of the box and come up with some creative solutions. Now, the green light has been given by Secretary of State for Transport, Grant Shapps, for drones to start delivering medical supplies in the UK. Now, this is going to be all new to everybody. So we want to know, how will this work and why drones? Why has that even come up as a suggestion? Well, Managing Director of commercial drones company Coptrz, Steve Coulson, is here to tell us a little bit more about what it is all about. Hi, Steve, and welcome to the show.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you. I'm looking forward to hearing more about this. I don't know if I'm just being a bit of a big kid and I'm just thinking of, you know, loads of movies that I've seen. But for anyone listening who might be a bit confused, when we say drone, what are we talking about exactly?
Well, a drone is, in essence, an aircraft that the pilot is on the ground and the pilot is controlling the drone remotely from the ground. And that can range from, you know, these little things you get at Christmas that weigh a few grams up to something that weighs several hundred kilos and operates thousands of miles from the pilot.
Wow. I mean, that already sounds incredible. And in this case, would it be a single pilot or would it be automated or how does that work?
I'm not 100% sure of all the details, but looking at similar projects, this will be flown from a ground control station, I believe, in Southampton, and it's a spin-off from the University of Southampton. And a ground control team will pilot this fixed-wing aircraft. So this is something akin to a kind of a microlight aircraft that you would see, you know, at a leisure aerodrome, mm-hmm. that will take off from Southampton, piloted by this ground control team. It will fly out from Southampton over the Solent to the Isle of Wight and deposit the medical supplies to the hospital near Newport on the Isle of Wight.
Do you think that the announcement is just the start in using drones as part of the COVID-19 plan?
Looking at other countries, yes, I do. I think they do have a very beneficial part to play in lots of different areas. You know, from the obvious like medical supply delivery, getting things to the front line, but also where it's been used in other countries, like the cleanup operation. Afterwards, mm-hmm. disinfecting areas where it's not really convenient or very quick for people, you know, humans to do it, but also getting information to people who maybe not listening to the news, etc., as well as things, let's say, where people might not be abiding by the rules and having nighttime gatherings where, you know, drones can use the thermal imaging cameras to identify people who might not be sort of toeing the line like the rest of us.
So there's lots of things that drones are capable of doing in a crisis like this. What's the situation of actually implementing them? Is there safety hurdles to overcome?
Yeah, I mean, there are quite tight safety hurdles, legislation in place for operating commercial drones, and that in essence limits you to a 500 metre radius of operation horizontally from the pilot and 400 foot ceiling altitude from the ground. Now, obviously, these drones that are going from Southampton to the Isle of Wight are working outside of that. And you can get special permissions for what's called BVLOS, beyond visual line of sight. And these, and us as well as the company have operated these drones at, you know, 10, 20, 30 kilometres away over land and sea. The police have been issued with more wide-ranging powers and the ability to use drones at further ranges now because of COVID-19 by the Civil Aviation Authority, because people are seeing that you know that they can offer a beneficial aid to you know the efforts that are going on.
Now, you've touched on some really good points there on how drones could be used positively, but why have in the past drones had a bad image?
People associate them first and foremost with the military drones, you know, attacking military targets from remote locations at the other side of the planet, and you know, all the connotations of that to, as with potential collateral damage and etc. And then you go to the other end, and you've got the toy drones that people may be putting up with a camera and invading people's privacy. Mm-hmm. But drones really do have, I know the people who are serious about them and operating them for commercial purposes, you know, we have a mantra of drones for good, and they can save lives. The police last year, I believe it was in Norfolk, it was one of the drones we provided them, they'd lost the pensioner. That pensioner had gone missing, and the ground searchers hadn't found anything, and they'd literally given up hope. They put a drone up in the air, and it found the pensioner stuck in a bog within 12 minutes. So, you know, the search and rescue angles are amazing. But also environmentally, it's more environmentally friendly to put a drone up than you're driving somewhere or put a helicopter up. And you're actually not putting people in unnecessary danger by using a drone. So I think, you know, as awful as this virus is, I think with many things we've seen in technology, like from things like people using virtual meetings, etc., that drones will be seen. We will start to see the benefits and people using them more and more for good purposes.
Well, we'll see them being used more and more, but once this initiative actually does take place, as and when, could this be the tides changing for the bad images that drones previously had, and people will start to see how much they can do in good?
I think you need those use cases. I think you need to, the authorities need to give, you know, the right organisations the ability to use drones more and more for good purposes. I mean, we're talking with the United Nations at the moment because for the World Food Programme, because one of the side effects of COVID-19 is the famines that it's going to cause through the third world, and the World Food Programme are wanting to use drones to you know, aid the humanitarian effort. So I think yes, you will be, as more and more people see it, they will make a differentiation between drones that are just, you know, being used to annoy people, or the sinister side that people may have put on military drones, to the amazing amounts of good that they can do.
Well, Steve, this all sounds very amazing. I mean, I'm looking forward to seeing the potential and what comes out of this, and I'm sure you are as well, of course, being the company Coptrz. And I mean, there's so many great points that you touched on of the potential of good that this can do. And with COVID-19, of course, we want to have anything at our disposal that we can do to help so many people that deserve it. So, Steve, thank you so much for being on the show, and we're looking forward to seeing the updates. But most of all, make sure you're staying safe.
Yeah, stay safe. Take care.
Thank you very much. BBC Radio Leeds, Sheffield and York. Really great there. Really insightful. Something different. Speaking to Steve Coulson, the Managing Director of commercial drones company Coptrz, on the potential of all the good that it could do with drones being given the green light to start delivering medical supplies in the UK.